Good morning, all of you. In Business Studies class 11th, we are on chapter 1, and our today's topic is one branch of commerce. First was trade, we already completed, and today we are moving towards the next branch, that is aids to trade, or you can say auxiliaries to trade. Auxiliaries to trade means helping hand for trade. So today I am going to explain you auxiliaries to trade. See, helping hand to trade. Banking, insurance, communication, transportation, warehouse, advertisement. There are various helping hands or aids or auxiliaries for our trade. So today's topic is aids to trade, and these will be in chapter 4 also in business services. So aids to trade, the activities which assist trade are called aids to trade. The activities which assist trade means all those activities which are helpful for business are known as auxiliaries to trade. Shall I explain you this one? Then we will move towards. Auxiliaries to trade means helping hand to trade, those activities which are helpful, which are assisting the trade are known as auxiliaries to trade. Then next, auxiliaries to trade or aids to trade includes transport, banking, insurance, warehousing, advertising, etc. These service enterprises facilitate movements, means transportation. Finance means banks. Risk coverage means insurance. Storage means warehouses. And sales promotion means advertising of goods. So my dear children, today I am going to explain you what are the auxiliaries to trade, aids to trade, what is it meaning? See, aids to trade means those services which are helpful or facilitate movements of goods from producer to consumer. So all those things, all those activities which are helpful to trade, which are aids to trade, auxiliaries to trade, which makes the life easy for businessman, that will be included in aids to trade. Transportation. See, as you know, the goods cannot move from one place to another without help of transportation. I gave you the example. Apples produced in Jammu and Kashmir and Shimla and available in Kanyakumari with the help of transportation. Banking helps in finance, accepting deposits, giving loans, online payments, other services also they are giving to businessmen. Then insurance. Insurance minimizes the risk factor. Risk coverage, they share the loss of the business at the time of mishappening, fire insurance, marine insurance. Then warehousing. Warehousing means children go down, cold storages. I will explain you about that. They are helpful for storage of goods. They protect the goods from leakage, spoilage, damage. Then advertising. See, advertising is necessary for every business. Advertising makes the buying and selling convenient. That's why for the promotion, sales promotion of goods, for launching a new product, for introduction, for influence advertising is necessary. So in this topic we will study about these auxiliaries. Then first is transportation and communication. Do you think without transportation and communication business can survive? Absolutely, your answer will be no. See, transport and communication, usually production takes place in certain locations and consumption in all over the part of the country. This problem is removed by transport through various modes: roadways, railways, airways, waterways. Simple concept is that without mode of transportation, production and consumption will not go smoothly. Production takes place at some certain location, but consuming all over the part of the country. And this gap, place gap, is filled up by the transportation. And in previous classes, you have learned about modes of transportation like roadways, railways, waterways, airways. Now, next, communication. Along with transport, communication is also very essential, which helps the producers, traders, and consumers in exchange of information. See, communication means exchange of ideas, information, knowledge, emotions. So communication is very essential for the businessman also, for giving order, for taking order, for taking information about the product, about the payment. That's why communication is essential. It helps the producers, traders, and consumers in exchange of information. See, postal services, telephones, and other modern means of communication may be regarded as auxiliaries to business activities. Okay, postal services means services provided by post office. Telephone, mobile, modern means of communication are there. They all help, they are helpful for the business. That's why we can say transportation and communication are the essential part for smooth operating of business activities or trade activities. See, without communication, a producer is living in Jammu and Kashmir, and consumer or the buyer or trader is in Kerala. How they will communicate? They will communicate through telephone. Other modes of communication are also there for giving order, for taking information, for related with terms and conditions. That's why we can say communication is essential. Then banking and finance. All business concerns need fund for acquiring asset, for raw material, for meeting day-to-day expenses. So the finance is the foundation of all business provided by banks. Without finance, no one can survive, no business can run, no trade activities can be performed. See, businessman needs fund for purchasing assets, for raw material. They require banks for depositing their surplus money, for taking loan, for online payment, for other services like checkbook, passbook, overdraft facilities. So banking and finance are necessary for trade. Then see how banks help the business. What are the functions performed by commercial banks? banks accept deposits from the public and provide credit facilities, loans, short term, middle term, long term loans, and overdraft facilities to businessmen. They lend money, overdraft, cash credit, loans, discounting of bills, collection of checks, remittance facilities, and various other services to the business community. Online payment, online information, everything whichever is required by the businessman regarding finance and bank will facilitate. So bank accepts deposit also and giving loans to businessmen. They provide various types of accounts facility like current account, saving account, fixed deposit account, recurring deposit accounts. We will explain you further. Then next is insurance. Yes. Insurance provides protection against the risk of loss due to accident, fire, earthquake, theft, damage of goods, in stock, in transit. So by paying a nominal fees, which is known as premium, the amount of loss can be shared. See, insurance minimizes the risk factor. Insurance cannot eliminate the risk. Natural calamity, loss, accident, fire, earthquake, all things are there. Maybe loss by theft, loss by other reasons, loss by goods in transit. Insurance minimizes the risk factor by sharing the risk. But for insurance compensation, the insurer should pay some nominal amount, which is known as premium. The next is warehousing. Do you think whenever the goods produced that can be consumed immediately? No. Goods produced somewhere else before the consumption, but used in future dates. So warehouses are helpful for keeping the goods safely and in good condition so everyone can use it whenever required. Warehouses protect the goods from leakage, spoilage, damage. See, production is always in anticipation of future demands so that the producers are to be kept in good condition until they are sold. So warehouses facilitates storage of goods and stabilize prices by equalizing supplies. So in common terms, warehouses means godowns for storage and cold storage. I will explain you this topic in chapter 4. Then last is advertising. Advertising helps to reach millions of customers for promoting sales, giving information about the product. Advertising makes possible marketing of goods and services on a large scale. Yes, print media. See, advertising helps to make the buying and selling convenient, easy, helpful for, to ease, make the launching easy. And it gives the information about the product. See, if you want to buy a camera, you can see the advertisements given by many film stars. You can see the brochures, you can see the details. Then it's easy for you to judge which product is good for you. So advertising, then as you all required that, ma'am, at the end you should summarize it. So see, aids to trade, auxiliaries to trade, transportation, communication, banking, insurance, warehousing, advertising. all are helpful for business activities. So today I completed aids to trade, sea, transportation, roadways, railways, airways, waterways, communication, postal communication, telecom communication, phone, etc. Then banks, financial institutions, then insurance. Insurance minimizes the risk factor. Then warehouses, godowns. Godowns are necessary to keep surplus production. And at the end, advertising. So my dear children, all these are business services as well as aids to trade or auxiliaries to trade. All are helpful for making the trade process, buying and selling process smooth. All these activities are helpful for producers and traders. See, without transportation, goods cannot be moved from one place to another. Without modes of communication, information or buying and selling is not possible. Without banking and financial sector, businessmen cannot deposit extra surplus money or take loan. Insurance is necessary for minimizes the risk factor. Warehouses are also necessary to keep the surplus production and to keep the goods safe in good condition. And then advertising. Advertisings are mode of advertising are helpful for introduction, for sales promotion. See, nowadays businessmen are using film stars, sports personalities to advertise their goods. Okay, so all these are helpful for trade.